Let's talk about the VMA next carpet.
Jewel. I gotta bust down my jewel.
That would be iconic if you bust that down.
If you've been around a high school or college campus, or maybe even middle school in the last few years, you've probably seen kids smoking this. This is a Juul, the most popular brand of e-cigarette, and while it might look just like a USB drive, it's at the center of a battle between the tobacco industry and the government that looks a lot like something we've been through once before. This is how we got here.
Everything is bust down. For sure. Let's talk about the VMA
next
carpet.
Juul. I gotta bust down my Juul.
That would be iconic if you bust that down.
Juul, the Silicon Valley startup, are the makers of a sleek vaping device. It exploded in popularity after just 4 years on the market. I visited Eric Pai, who owns a smoke shop in Williamsburg, Brooklyn, where Juul is his bestseller.
Is it cool if I see one of the packages from one of the Juul?
Oh
packages?
Yeah, absolutely. I'll give you the good one, the mango.
The good one, okay. And do you have
the coveted
a Juul
mango
device?
Right here, you can try this one.
Okay.
And all you gotta do, this is a battery, and you just take your cartridge and put it in here. And that's it. And that's why it's so popular. It's very slick, it's very small. Cigarettes kill 500,000 people a year in America. You know, people might be getting addicted to it, but this might be a way healthier choice, and it might be slowing down a major epidemic, the major epidemic of our time. It's never gonna be cigarettes.
As bad as cigarettes.
It's not gonna be in the same level of cigarettes. It's just not that sort of thing.
When you say everyone does it, do you literally mean everyone is doing it, or?
Not like everyone, but I would say like 90%.
I'd say a really high percentage of kids have at least tried it once.
Like you could walk into like a school's bathroom and you know you just smell it.
And is it something that like only the cool kids are doing, or is it just like something that?
No,
honestly,
no.
It's everybody. It's a lot of kids who are doing it. The kids who are out having fun. Also the kids who are alone in their rooms just studying. It's everybody.
Do you remember the first time you saw it?
Yeah, I was what? I was like 12 or something.
Eighth grade.
How was it? Like I started at the end of eighth grade, and I did it for a while. Like I tried to quit for a while. I did it for a while. I failed at quitting for a while. But like.
Now you're totally clean.
Nah, I wouldn't say completely totally, but like I haven't done it in a long time, probably a month and a half, 2 months or something. And like, I don't plan on doing it anytime in like the near future, but like, I can't say I'm never gonna do it again because there are Juuls always floating around, being passed around, and I can't say I'm never gonna like take another hit.
Right.
Juul was created by James Monsees and Adam Bowens, two former smokers and Stanford design graduates. Back when Monsees and Bowens were designing the device that would later become Juul, they even hinted that their original motivation was to create a new, cooler method of smoking. Juul's explosion on the market with flavors like mango, mint, creme brulee, and fruit medley coincided with the youth vaping trend considered by the FDA as a new public health crisis.
When you see all of the flavored pods and stuff like that, do you feel like Juul was like specifically marketed towards your demographic?
100%. Like, just seems a little unnecessary to have the flavors around. You know, it figures because mint and mango, which are flavors that a smoker would not really identify with, are the most popular flavors, you know, amongst teens, so.
Is that the flavor that you guys see amongst your friends?
Yeah, it's mostly mint and mango because, I mean, mint is like, it's a cool feeling in your throat. You don't really feel the burn. It's kind of just like chewing a piece of gum, and I mean, like, who doesn't like to chew gum?
Right.
Studies show that teens, not older smokers, are now the ones most likely to be Juul users. Vaping has increased nearly 80% among high schoolers and 50% among middle schoolers between 2017 and 2018. I spoke to Dr. Robert Jackler, a Stanford professor who is an expert on the impact of tobacco marketing and studies the rapid rise of Juul.
Juul changed the world of vaping. So the world of vaping 4 years ago when they came around was mostly very low nicotine. But now Juul came out with nicotine that is 3 or 4 times more concentrated than was typical then, a really big punch.
Like the thing about like the Juul is that it's like made differently, the nicotine in the pod. So it goes into your bloodstream faster, it hits you harder, and it gives you a longer and like better kind of feeling than like a cigarette would because of the nicotine salts that they use. And it's also a lot more concentrated too.
A single Juul pod puts as much nicotine in the bloodstream as an entire pack of 20 Marlboro cigarettes.
Honestly, for someone who's young, who's trying, who's never like smoked a cigarette before, doesn't have any pre-built up tolerance to nicotine, when they're getting this such a high level of nicotine so quickly when they're that age, it's really hard not for a kid to get addicted, because it's just science, it's just what happens.
Juul's early marketing in its first year on the market was very much oriented towards young people. It used, young adults, in their 20s, but they were doing playful things the way a high school or middle school kid might. And they were the type of advertisements that very much appealed to young people, including the underage set, not yet of legal age to buy tobacco products or nicotine products in general.
How old do you have to be to buy it?
You can literally just go in the store and buy it.
Yeah,
they don't really. That's
true. Oh, they don't check.
You're supposed to be 21.
But you go to the bodega.
But you go to the right bodega and they'll just let you buy it.
Or online too. Like if you go to the Juul website, they have all those age verification stuff. If you go to like eBay or something, there's no age verification on that. There's no way to stop people from doing that unless it's one of those things that's banned from the site.
The way Juul advertised early on mirrors what big tobacco companies did for most of the last century. This past December, one of the largest tobacco companies in the world invested nearly $13 billion into Juul, which doesn't exactly help Juul's argument that they're the anti-cigarette. Skyrocketing rates of addiction in young people and the eerily close relationship to big tobacco are the reasons why many parents are freaking out.
There were times when I woke up in the middle of the night and I was sweating. And there have been times like where I just get overly aggressive. The thing about Juul is that everyone from a young age, especially now with our friends, have always been told like, oh, cigarettes are bad for you, because that's kind of what the science has showed and that's what they were taught and that's what we kind of learned. But now that kids are starting to Juul, it's kind of like a not as bad thing. There's no stigma towards it as much. And that's kind of desensitizing people to cigarettes too, because once they start using a Juul, it's like, oh, this is a nicotine device, oh, the cigarette's not that much worse, and you kind of just move yourself from Juuling to cigarettes based on just telling yourself that it's not that much worse.
Like, it's kind of like an epidemic. Like, so many kids do it, it's gonna ruin our generation because everyone's just so addicted.
We're kind of just like the damage control. Instead of saving our generation, it's more about protecting the next generation.
In September 2018, the FDA deemed teenage vaping an epidemic and launched the, quote, largest coordinated enforcement effort in its history. In November, Juul announced they would stop selling flavored pods in retail locations and deleted all of their social media accounts. Lawsuits are piling up from people accusing the company of basically acting like Big Tobacco did a generation ago, trying to addict new and young customers to nicotine. Eric Pai has some of the last flavored pods out there. They used to go for $20, but with the demand so high, he's now selling for $40 each.
The reality is there is no supply for flavored Juul for us. You know, we're about to run out on that. And, we're talking about addiction. So if you can't get your Mango device, you might just go smoke a cigarette instead.
Juul has officially said that they do not market toward children, and it's illegal for anyone under 18 to buy the product. Juul released a statement on the matter saying, "We don't want anyone who doesn't smoke or already use nicotine to use Juul products. We certainly don't want youth using the product. It is bad for public health and it is bad for our mission." But Scott Gottlieb, the former head of the FDA, said the actions by Juul wouldn't be enough. He took to Twitter to say, "We are deeply concerned about the epidemic of youth use of e-cigs. Voluntary action is no substitute for regulatory steps FDA will soon take." Despite the increased scrutiny, Juul doesn't seem to be slowing down anytime soon. The company is now worth $38 billion, and the company expects $3.4 billion in revenue in 2019. It's hard to claim they're not just another tobacco company when their investors are the same exact people that addicted a generation of smokers. And even if regulations are set in place, has the damage already been done?
Do you guys wish that you never started Juuling in the first place?
Yeah.
Yes.
But yeah.